Good morning. This is Thursday, May 6th, and I'd like to begin by wishing Rose Marie a happy birthday. We haven't seen you in a bit, Rose, but we're so glad you're part of our fellowship and your daughter and grandkids. We love them dearly. So happy birthday, Rose. Hope you have a great day. Today's devotion is Liberty and the Standards of Jesus. This is Galatians 5. Stand fast, therefore, in the liberty by which Christ has made us free. The spiritually minded person will never come to you with a demand, believe this and believe that. A spiritually minded person will demand that you align your life with the standards of Jesus. We are not asked to believe the Bible, but to believe the one whom the Bible reveals to us. That's John 5. We are called to present liberty for the conscience of others, not to bring them liberty from their thoughts and their opinions. And if we ourselves are free with the liberty of Christ, others will be brought into that same liberty, the liberty that comes from realizing the absolute control and authority of Jesus Christ. And there's so much release built into that. We don't have to be in charge. And isn't that a wonderful feeling? He's in charge. We just go and do as he leads us to go and do. One of the things that I learned in the military about being in charge is not it's all cracked up to be. So he's saying we don't have to be in charge. Christ has this thing. Always measure your life solely by the standards of Jesus. Submit yourself to his yoke and his alone. And always be careful never to place a yoke on others that is not of Jesus Christ. And that can happen very easily in a church setting. With all the joy that can fly around and all the activity, sometimes we can yoke people in that God's not asked them to be yoked to. So we got to be careful that we don't put our yoke on somebody else or receive a yoke that's not of Christ. It takes God a long time to get us to stop thinking that unless everyone sees things exactly as we do, then they must be wrong. And for reference to that, I always tell folks to look at the Gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, especially the first three. They're called the Synoptic Gospels. And the stories are the same, but they all saw it from their perspective. There's nothing wrong with them, but each man saw it from their perspective, but it's still God's word. And that's what he's saying. Don't disagree with everybody and think because they don't see things the way you see things, like Matthew, Mark, and Luke, that they're wrong. That's never God's view. There is only one true liberty, the liberty of Jesus at work in our conscience, enabling us to do what is right. Don't get impatient with others in regards to that agreement thing. Remember how God dealt with you, with patience and gentleness. But never, in the same breath, never water down the truth. Let it have its way and never apologize for it. Jesus said, go and make disciples. That's Matthew 28. He did not say, make converts to your own thoughts and your own opinions. The challenge I have for us today is, when was the last time that we presented our testimony to someone? When is the last time we told somebody about Jesus as per the Word of God and personal experience? I want to challenge you to do it today. I want you to find somebody to share your witness with today. Give them your testimony. Even if it's somebody that knows you and they know that you're saved, take the time to exercise your testimony. That exercise helps us begin to see where we're stepping in instead of allowing God to step in. So find somebody today and give them your testimony. Let's pray. Father, I thank you that you challenge us to give folks your word and your word alone. We are not to manufacture things out of our own opinions, but we are to take them from the word of God as led by the Holy Spirit. So Father, today I pray that we would find someone, perhaps our spouse even, to share our testimony with, to really take the time to sit down and tell them about what Christ has done in our lives. We thank you, Lord, for the gift of salvation, and we ask that you would help us stretch our faith in these days ahead. We ask this in Christ's name. Amen. God bless. I'll see you tomorrow.